Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm going to speak about a very interesting topic, LLM hallucinations, why this happens and how we can mitigate the effects of this problem. Essentially, hallucinations is when your model is just answering you something that is either incorrect or drive you to take an incorrect decision, so misleading you with the answer that is providing to you. Usually they present an answer like a fact when it's probably, well, most likely wrong, no? This is a problem that happens with all LLMs, and it's well, due to the nature how they are designed to predict the most likely word, to generate the most likely word which better match the query which better match the answer of the query that you make to the LLM. In some cases, depending on your configuration and some other factors that we will cover now, just the model just somehow invent the answer that is providing to you after an answer. And why this happens? Well, the main reason that this happened is because of the training data. We cover this several times in different videos. I already showed you this in previous videos that I upload to the channel. In any other model in AI, in machine learning, deep learning, generative AI is not, it's just a subset of the and a specific kind of the AI models, like in any other model. And for those that are practitioners in ML, in AI, we perfectly know that the quality of data is key on how the model is going to behave at prediction time. So we perfectly know that the low quality data or insufficient not enough data to train your model is gonna drive in have poor answers from your model, poor prediction, poor forecast. And then we perfectly know that. Also, feature engineering, not knowing exactly what the data is telling to you, not doing a correct exploratory data analysis, so you don't understand the data, and the data, what the model is predicting, is just a reflect of what you use to train the model. This is the main and key factor of this happening. So we perfectly know, machine learning practitioners, that an incorrect preparation of your training data is gonna drive in poor predictions, overfitting, and all the problems that are derived for this matter. So that's why it's a key part in any process when you are building a machine learning system, an AI component, that spend time, understand exactly the data, the problem, how you are going to create features and etc. And why? Because this is key and very important for the output of your models. And exactly the same for generative AI, for an LLM, which essentially is taking information from the data that you train the model. One thing that we already know is something that I already showed you as well in some of the videos, is the models are also predicting or giving you an answer based on the information that they know from the training data. And then I make you in some of the videos I posted before, asking the videos to tell me, for example, who is the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, no, or the UK. And then the models, even GPT-4, but in that case I was trying with GPT 3.5 Turbo, the model say acts or answer is Boris Johnson, which is not true, because but what happened there is the model was trained, the model can only answer you with the information that had on the weights that is using to providing you an answer. And these weights are coming from the training data. And in the training data, that was the only information available, the model cannot produce any other information. And if it produces another information that is, in that case, not Boris Johnson, is going to be fake as well, it's going to be wrong. So this problem is happening among all the LLMs. So you have that day when you train your model, when you release your model, and everything that happened after that, the model is not aware of that. And then there is techniques, as you probably know, RAG and others, that provide context, provide additional information, or introduce additional information into the loop in order to avoid this problem. But again, for this problem, for this specific problem, for AI hallucination, LLM hallucination, one of the main problems is the data we use for the for train the model. Not only hallucinations, also, and you also probably know that is causing or provoking bias in terms of the gender, in terms of the other key and very sensitive topics today. Again, gender or probably age or race, these kind of things today also are affecting the answers that the LLMs are producing. This is another topic, no? How we avoid the bias and making the as well the LLMs safe and how to say and producing answers that are worthy, no? That are something useful for the user. This is another topic, but it's also somehow connected with what we are discussing here. So at the end, again, this is not more than a model with a state-of-the-art technique, which suffers in somehow the same problems that we are suffering with the ML or deep learning models in the previous years, no? And then probably this is nothing new, what you see overfitting. This is not, this is something that affect as well ML models, deep learning models. When the model is learning the data that you training, that you are using for training, is a really bad signal. And then on why? Because it's not able to generalize. And then it's a problem in a, with a, with an a, with a deep learning model, just for classification. It's a problem for an LLM, and it's a problem for whatever model that you have. It's always an issue that when your model learn the data, learn the patterns of the data that you use for training, and it's not able to generalize. This also, again, cause this problem of hallucination. But this is more, these two first, that these are general problems of ML, is obviously affecting as well, and one of the main reasons as well of AI hallucinations. The third, idioms and slang expression. Well, I like to say with that this is not only LLMs. Probably even you or me, we have problems with idioms or slangs even in your mother tongue. The model in your native language, because you are not aware of all idioms or slang expressions that you have in your own language. Even imagine the slang or idioms that you have in a foreign language that you don't master, and this is happening exactly the same for AIs, for LLMs. When you are training your data, you may know, regardless the vast or big is the number of data sets that you use to train a model, is incomplete. Probably you miss something. For sure you miss something. How, what percentage? You don't know. And then this is very specific topic in NLP, idioms and slang, that probably it will take a long time after this is solved. No? And it's very, as many of these idioms and slang expressions are related to a very small area. And then, well, in that specific place, or if somebody using these specific expressions, the LLM is not going to understand the same that you probably, or the same than me. We are not going to understand what this person is trying to say, or what is the real meaning of that, no? And then knowing how it works, transformers, and then you will see a combination of the of words in some positions that it doesn't match the normal how to say frequency for those words in the dictionary that the transformer or the model was training with the original data set. And then on another topic that is very hot as well to these days, the adversarial attacks. This is not only for AI hallucination. They try to provoke AI hallucinations to drive the model to answer, for example, with private information from patients. For example, with answering something that is unsafe, like tell me how to hack a router, or tell me how to break a ATM or a cash machine. These kind of things, adversarial attack is a very hot topic today, not only in LLMs, also in deep learning and machine learning, because it's not only driving or trying to cheat an LLM to extract information or to use the capabilities of an LLM to provide dangerous information or information about something that it shouldn't provide, like for example private data from customers or again passwords, ways to break into a system or ways to break into a property, these kind of things. Now, and today is really very hot topic as well. Many people researching about how to avoid adversarial attack, not only for LLMs, also for any machine learning, deep learning model, because obviously, like behind it, any security, cyber security problem, there is always a interest, mostly financial interest, usually 99% of financial interest, or only in other cases it's just to, well, destroy reputations or destroy the key infrastructures or key services of the company. But at the end of the day, always money behind and causing problems to the users or persons that are using the systems. So, but mostly, and I also be working in cyber security for some years in the past, and most of the of cyber security attacks or cyber security problems are connected with financial problems. No, and then in order, if you want to extract some of the, I will give you an example. Probably you will understand better. No, some of the projects I made before for a pharmaceutical company, we create a model to some model that when it was running in a medical device. So one of the things that the authorities who had to approve the model to be running in a medical device that is later on is going to be used for a user or in a nursery is out of control. Everybody can use it. It's just a model, a small machine learning model, a classifier, which is running in a device that you can buy in a pharmacy or in a shopping mall to detect if you have a condition or not. And then one of the main concerns of the health authorities was somebody can infer the some data that from using the model. This is what exactly is adversarial attacks, no? If somebody can infer using any techniques, whatever, they don't care if the technique is sophisticated or not sophisticated. If somebody can infer from using the model any data or metadata of the patients or the of the patient that were used the information of the patient that were used to train these models. Obviously, to train a model for a medical device, you need to use real data. This real data, you cannot use synthetic data in this case. You need to use data for real patients because, well, this is you are working with health conditions, and then here is key that use real examples, no? And then this data had connections with patients' IDs, and also behind this data there is well, some metadata which connect with these images, these attributes with a person, and then, well, this is protected by law in Europe, in United States, everywhere. And then there is now a very big concern everywhere how models, for example, in this industry can be attacked to, how to say, infer any kind of information from the data that was used to train those models, no? Because obviously the hackers, they are not stupid. If somebody believes that, they are completely wrong. They know that we need to use real data to train this kind of models, and then if they can infer any kind of information from the model, and the adversary attack is that simple, that try and error, and it finally you can infer a pattern, you may get finally understanding if the user was there or not inside the training data. Well, this is a very interesting topic as well. I know a little bit about that. And then, well, again, AI hallucinations can be used as well with adversarial attack, not for that purpose or even for that purpose, but also, for example, to provoke that cheating or try to cheat the model with an adversarial attack, extract information, for example, to create a bomb, or to hack a system, or to break into a house or break into a property. This kind of thing is what they are covering with these adversarial attacks, no? So, what produced this adversarial attacks is what is producing AI hallucinations. Sorry. I provide you here as well a couple of the links just to you review the topic. One is from Google. This is very good, and this is something as well that I found out that's very interesting. Just you can take a look, and you can find as well some other information, that there is plenty of info available on the internet. And then on here some mitigation strategies. Everything how to say circle around limiting, no, the capabilities or telling exactly the model how he had to answer. This is key. I make sometimes the simile that a model, a LLM, is like a kid, no, and you have to tell him exactly. It's a kid, very clever kid, that he knows a lot of things, but it's very, sometimes it's very nasty. It can behave not very well, no? And then if you tell him very clear, you establish the limits of what he can do, or the kid can do, and you just tell him, well, you have to do this, and you have to do it this way, and you had to follow these steps. And then on, if you limit everything correctly, it's gonna happen that, no? And this is something similar, no? You just say the model, you had to do this, you had to do it this way, and you can't do this, I want it this way, you shouldn't do that, and that is, no, this is exactly what they say, limit the possible outcomes. You don't need to give the possibility to invent. You just say answer yes or not. That's it. Limit the possible. And if there is five classes, just answer me with one word. red, green, blue, yellow, black. No, I don't care the rest. That is one of the strategies, very successful strategy to avoid this problem. The second, connecting with the data. For example, if you are working in building a bot which is specialized in data in your company. By the way, I uploaded recently a video just to work with the LangChain, with chatbots in LangChain, and there where I show you how to create a specialized bot in some information. You want to do something similar, not a bot which is specialized in data in your company. And then, well, you trust in that data. This data, probably these policies, these documents, these procedures, this whatever, this database is in your company, is curated, you trust on that. And then don't introduce noise on that process. If you now this LLM connected to another tooling, for example, connect this and make an additional search, for example, in internet, you are introducing an unnecessary noise on the loop. If you have data which is relevant for the topic and you trust on that, use that and no more. You don't need to use more. So the LLM is capable enough to use this data, and with the native capabilities of a model and a good data is gonna get you very good answers. If you don't need more, don't try to connect 20 different sources for something, because the only thing that you are doing is introducing noise into the system. This create data template for the model, this is something that we cover as well with LangChain. It's just, well, I give you a text and I want you to return me this text in this format. We use for that Pydantic, this class data type checking in Python, and you just tell here, well, look, I want that you extract from this document the ID, the name, the address and the telephone, and the description of the name is blah blah blah, the description of the address is this, the description of that, and if it is possible to tell you even the format, the best. So this, what is doing, is exactly the same that we make in the point number one, limit the possible outcomes. If you don't specify correctly this on your template, on your prompt, yeah, you are giving the chance to the model to think, it's just to choose something that is not probably what you are looking for or what you expect. No? Also, this is interesting, give the AI a specific role. If you don't give a specific role, the role is by default is just I'm a useful chatbot or a useful tool, and I will provide the answer, the best answer of my knowledge. But if you say to the AI that your role is you are an expert in quantical mechanics or infinitesimal mathematics, and you ask the model to this LLM, well, can you give me a receipt how to prepare paella? The model is going to say, I have no idea about how to prepare paella. I'm a specialist in infinitesimal mathematics or quantical computation or whatever, no? Reduce or give a role to the AI when you initialize the LLM, and this will limit as well or provide a context to the LLM in what he had to answer and in which scope of answer he had to work. And you can simply tell him not to lie. It's the same that you saw some of the other videos I published. We ask the model just let's think step by step. This is also working. Just tell, if you don't know the answer, I prefer you to tell me I don't know the answer. Don't invent. And the LLM is going to do it. Believe me. So it's just you need to ask him. So if we again, it's how to say, I make the same similar than before. It's like a kid, no? That you just have to tell you what is possible to do, what is not possible to do, which is the point number five. Tell him what you want and what you don't want. And very simple. And the six, and the number six is the temperature. As you may know, the temperature is this parameter which play a role in the randomness that is introduced on the answers. Temperature close of zero is no randomness, and temperature close to one or above is a lot of randomness. And then you see, as you know how transformers works, or all this model is just providing the most likely. So if you have a temperature of zero, it will give you the most likely word or token next time, according to the that better suit or match the answer. So the better suits or bet yeah better suit or match the answer according to the query that you send to the LLM. If you introduce temperature, what you are doing is giving the chance to other tokens to play in that game, no? It will be also possible not to pro not to to pro to get you the most likely token. Also, it will be possible to get you some other tokens. And as much temperature you provide to the system, as much temperature you set up on the system, there is more tokens that are more possible and are playing also playing at the same level to the most likely token, to the most next likely token. So more temperature, more creativity. Less temperature, less creativity. And then on, this is something that you need to experiment, and depending on your use case, you may need something that is creative. You are working with something that is art, or you are doing probably you need something that is creative. But if you are working, for example, with the chain of truth, you don't need creativity at all. You need to solve the problem. You need to solve the mathematical problem. You need to solve the hypothesis. You need to solve something that they don't need creativity. So we need to know how to play with this attribute. Okay, and well, that's all. And then let's go to the game. I make some examples. For the first one, I use a Mistral 7B. You probably know it's a small model in comparison with the second one we will use, but with both I made the same game, no? This is a well-known hallucination problem, no? We are asking the model to count how many M's are in the world weather. Think that here there is a trick on this word, on this sentence, is because the S is kind of the existent word in all LLMs, no? And then when you ask this to the model is telling us, ooh, model to device, exactly. Encoders, models, temperature, yeah, preprint. Let me execute it again just to, we will do this again. Yeah, the problem is I was executing this before, and then on our now let me 1 second have to now nah, it's fine. Now we run the model again, so you will see now the model is generating, yeah, and then yeah, the world weather contains 2 M's. Okay, this is completely wrong, no? You probably know that weather doesn't contain any M. And then I prepare now a message that if you saw the videos before, just here, just we are creating a Sorry, here is here. Well, we can review the previous answer. Look at this, I'm just creating the context for the next question, and then the next question I'm asking the model, are you sure of the answer? You see what the model was telling me before, how many M's are the word weather? This is the user message, then on I use the assistant, and I provide the message that he provided me before. Answer me whether contain two M's, blah blah blah. He gives me very long message here. And then on, I create include for the next question role user again, user message. The content is, are you sure of your answer? And what the model answer me, yes, I'm sure of my answer that the word weather contain two M's. Sounds even it doesn't not contain two M letters when written. So it's inventing, absolutely inventing. Well, try to home with this. You will have a little bit fun on that. And then I try with OpenAI as well. This I think I present you this in some of the videos I uploaded weeks ago. We try with GPT 3.5 Turbo. It's not the last, but believe me, it happens as well with GPT 4. We made the same. You are a bot, a helpful assistant, blah, blah, blah. And I asked the same question. Look at the question. There is one N on the word weather. But it seems that the GPT 3.5 Turbo was trained a little bit better than Mistral 7B. And you may see here, once we introduce again the first human message, the answer of the LLM, and then on the human message again, with this test 1 and test 2. Test 1 is how many N's and in the world weather, and test 2, are you sure of your answer? And then now GPT 3.5 Turbo answer correctly. But again, this can happen anytime. So we need to be aware of the problem. We need to know how to solve it. And there is other techniques that we will cover later on, mostly connected to how to reduce bias and make that response had a value, an intrinsic value, and there is not the model is not answering something that is not, is trash. No, you probably know as well what happened on any digital system or any data system, which is always the same. That is, if you introduce trust, you are going to receive trust. The same happen with LLMs. Trust in, trust out. And then here is happening the same. And then on this video, so we will prepare later with the reinforcement learning for human feedback, no, and others. It will go more on the line of providing correct answers without bias, and answers that they are something that is helpful answers, no? That is something, some other topics that are also important. This is something that, again, we need to be aware of that. When we are producing a system, also depending, really heavily depending on your use case, it's not the same to create a bot just to answer IT questions in your company that and a bot that is going to do some medical diagnosis or driving a car or working with a plane to monitor the or help the pilot to do something, or here they say financial trading, where the losses is something is going wrong, or the LLM is driving you into a wrong decision. There is a human lives or a lot of money involved. Especially there are human lives involved. Well, we need to be aware of this, and we need to know how to minimize and detect and minimize the effects of these problems that are happening to any LLM. regardless, again, as I said, regardless how big is the data set. Moreover, as more data set you use to train your model, it's more difficult for the engineers who are working on that project to verify it all the data. Imagine that you are, for example, I don't know which model was, that they were using 1, 2, or 3 trillions of tokens. Who is checking the quality of this data? Nobody. There is no team in the world who can verify that the 3 million of tokens that they were using to train that model contains no bias, contains no problems, contains no errors, etc., etc. So this is something that we need to know that is going on. And we need to know how to detect it and how to mitigate the effects of that problem. Okay, that's all. I hope you like it, and I hope you enjoy and that you find it interesting and thought-provoking. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching. And if you like the video, as I say every time, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you and see you soon.